What is it like in terms of sunshade?
Yeah, it likes sunshine. Okay. It doesn't need the dirt. It'll grow in from rumpy cat. It'll love rumpy cat.
Oh, that's a good one. Wonderful.
Shiva is my hero. Mm-hmm. See Freedom Lady? She's awesome.
There we go. Well, we're getting ready. That's it.
For our children, and their children's children, and the prosperity of life on Earth.
Can I give you some?
You know this.
Chocolate milk?
No.
The University of Toronto. Jacob is the founder of Occupy Gardens Toronto and is currently... Hello, Toronto! My name's Jennifer, and I moved to Toronto a couple years ago and went to a little march in Queen's Park. There were about 9 of us. Speaking of Occupy Monsanto, and after that march, we decided we needed to do something more. And James and I created Millions Against Monsanto, Toronto. And today we have over 2,500 people. From 9 people to 2,500. We're not here to say every single person that works for Monsanto is an evil, horrible person. Nobody's born evil. But they are brainwashed into thinking that they can control the earth and they can control our food systems, and we're not going to let them do it anymore.
And one of our new projects is the Toronto Seed Library. We currently have 5 branches up and running around the city of Toronto. On March 6th, we had a seed in at Toronto CD Hall, where we invited all of our CD counselors to join us, and we shared the seeds of food sovereignty. We even sent a special envoy of children up to the CD mayor's office. Oh. But as you can imagine, he was already engaged in other CD affairs. So by next spring, we're imagining hundreds of branches all around the city of Toronto, integrated within the public library system, schools, community centers, and celebrating Toronto's diverse neighborhoods. Imagine walking into your library and checking out free seeds, locally adapted, native, organic, open pollinated heirloom seeds, with all the information and knowledge and other resources to grow those seeds.
To learn the science as much as possible.
Turn around.
So that we can
That's better.
So that we know what we're talking about.
Which was to create awareness. Unfortunately,
Unfortunately, Proposition 37 was narrowly defeated because over $47 million was spent on untruthful and misleading ad campaigns in the days leading up to the vote. Paid for by companies that don't want you to know the truth about what they're putting in your food. Companies such as Monsanto, Dow Chemical, Kellogg's, Nestle, Kraft, Frito-Lay, and PepsiCo, to name a few. Over 60 countries around the world have mandatory GMO labeling, including China and Russia. Canada and the US are the only two industrialized nations that don't. In the countries that have mandatory labeling, products containing GMOs are hardly found because people won't buy them. Yeah. In fact, over 30 countries have outright bans on GMOs. Here, on the other hand, people know almost nothing about GMOs. A lot of people ask me, who's behind me? Why a kid like me, my age, is doing this? The response is simple. My parents are a huge support for me.
Say more to the mic.
They have to drive me to events like this. But truly, they are concerned about our future. They never had to deal with what we kids, your future leaders, are dealing with now. It's supposed to be a free country, but we don't even have the right to choose what we eat. The way I see it, our freedom was fought for by the Canadian troops in two world wars. And now Monsanto and the other biotech companies are taking away our freedom of choice. The way I see it for us, the youth, we have no future, no democracy.
Yeah.
I have to fight to gain that back. People believe that the government will protect them and wouldn't allow food to be consumed if it wasn't safe.
Not true.
Yet the government relies only on tests provided by the manufacturers to stand by selling their product. And yet Monsanto, one of the largest GMO seed companies, claims that food safety is the government's responsibility.
Bullshit.
Totally. I agree. The truth is, it's no coincidence that since GMOs have been introduced into our food system, we started seeing more cases of irritable bowel syndrome, leaky gut syndrome, acid reflux, infertility, cancer, autism,
Parkinson's,
and many other diseases. Unfortunately, it seems like we're all a big part of a science experiment. But the truth is out. It's spreading, and it can't be stopped. It won't be stopped.
Can we go?
I think somebody here said, If Monsanto was so proud of their product, then why don't they label it?
Exactly.
And I think that says it all.
Well,
partying all my last days. Your heart is in it. Nothing happened.
We're here. We're here.
I had a
way to go, Montana!
We're going to be marching soon, but I'm going to tell you a little story before we do that.
Use your outside voice.
Can you hear me back there?
Better!
Okay. I'm Montana Jones, and apparently I'm bombed and dangerous. But I'm not a criminal. I'm a shepherd, a farmer, been conserving rare breed Shropshire sheep for about the last 13 years, and various other heritage breeds and vegetables for the last 30. So how is it that the Canadian Food Inspection Agency has charged myself, raw milk activist and farmer Michael Schmidt, and two others with 9 criminal charges, including conspiracy?
What?
$100,000 in legal fees for the upcoming trial, and if convicted, we face 12 years in jail
and
a $1.5 million fine.
No!
All for allegedly trying to save Canada's heritage sheep and preserve our country's agricultural biodiversity.
Thank you!
In the last decade, 60 breeds of sheep, cattle, goats, pigs, and poultry have become extinct. Why save them? Well, heritage breeds are to the barnyard what non-GMO seeds are to the garden. They're tasty, traditional, hardy, disease-resistant, and grow superbly on grass pasture alone. No Monsanto grain required. Do you realize that 90% of all the food that we consume comes from only 8 animal breeds? Many of them are unable to reproduce on their own and rely on antibiotics, hormones, and cheap GMO grain to be fattened quickly. It's just not natural, but heritage breeds are. So that's what I raise.
Thank you!
3 years ago, the CFIA swooped down on my little farmstead and declared that a ewe I sold many years ago had tested positive for a sheep disease called scraping. My flock had never had a single symptom or sign, and CFIA agreed that that sheep could have been infected after it left my farm. So they did live tests. How's that?
Louder!
So they did live tests. All results came back negative. Surely that should have been the end of it. But it was not. The CFIA ordered and issued an order to kill my entire flock anyway. Just in case, they said.
Fuck that, yo.
That's like eradicating all the redheads here just in case we might get sunburned. I pleaded alternatives to killing them and offered a proposal to find out if they actually had the disease while still preserving them and their genetics.
Pulling an Andrew.
Activist farmer Joel Salatin pleaded. So did the president of the Rare Breed Survival Trust in England. But our Minister of Agriculture, Jerry Ritz, ignored them. He also ignored the over 5,000 people that had signed a petition asking that he reconsider and handle the situation differently. So, in fact, the CFIA destroyed my beautiful sheep.
No!
Really just to find out if they were healthy. And they were. And now they are dead. You may wonder why our government is spending so much money on a sheep disease that affects just a handful of sheep every year. And it does not affect human health. Well, they will tell you that it's in Canada's best interests to increase resistance to scraping so that it does not become a trade barrier in the future. So in other words, for money. Our rare heritage genetics mean nothing, but big ag means more. The CFI is not pleased with me for going public about their actions. I was
necessary for the triumph of evil. Today that's gonna change.
Yeah.
I'm glad that James is able to tell you a little bit about myself, because I didn't want you to think some crazy guy just with tattoos grabbed the mic and started talking up here. But regardless of that, I want to speak about two companies. Like, when I came to Toronto, when I moved to Toronto first, I worked at the Big Carrot for 2.5 years, and I worked with Vega a little bit. Now, the Big Carrot, if many of you are from Toronto, if you need to know what's in your food, most of you want to know right now, go to the Big Carrot. They have a 99.1% guarantee that you will not have genetically modified organisms in your products, in your food that you're buying. They also were in collaboration with starting the non-GMO project. This is what we need to do. You can't battle with Monsanto in the boxing ring. They have too much money. There's a sign right there, $3 billion in annual profit. You can't battle them in the boxing ring. You have to start grassroots movements like we're doing today. The non-GMO project is one of them that allows companies to sign up for 10 years, I believe, within the non-GMO project, and they will never use GMOs in their product. They will label it for you. These are companies that are voluntarily labeling their food for you. Let's give them respect. Now, it doesn't matter. I want to bring one other thing up, and that is really quickly, Vega too. Vega's a great company out of BC. I actually sat down with Brendan Brazier for dinner last year, and this guy is full of integrity. Let me tell you, Coca-Cola wanted to buy Vega from him. Guess what he said? No, he wouldn't sell it off. So they are looking to get verified GMO-free by this year as well, all the way down to the derivatives, so you can check that out too. There are companies out there with integrity. I just want to let you know, in the crowd, I'm sure we have vegans here. I'm sure we have vegetarians here. We don't need to go back and forth, but I'm sure we have paleos, I'm sure we have hunter-gatherers, I'm sure we have couch potatoes, I'm sure we have everybody. But we're all here for one reason, right? Most of us can agree that industrialized agriculture and this monopolization of our food has to stop. Now, we've been reading the papers lately, we've heard about Rob Ford, I don't need to talk about that. That's a joke and a half. We've heard about Prime Minister Harper, which is another joke and a half. In a time when our political vote seems to be cast into thin air,
no taxes.
This is what you got to vote with.
Yeah!
You're going to vote with your dollar from now on. Monsanto is scared of this. We spend this, whether you're spending it at Tim Hortons down the street, which I might remind you that on their cups it says caution hot water. When's it going to say caution GMOs? Yeah. Tell us about hot water, tell you about GMOs. You're going to bowl with your dollar from now on. If you take three things with you today, these are the three things I want you to take. Many of you might have heard of Bicot. Bicot is an application that is only available right now for Apple, I believe. You can download it on your iPhone. What you can do is scan your food, any products you can find, you scan it. This is going to tell you the lineage, the family tree of where your money's going. Does it go to Nestle? Does it go to Coca-Cola? Does it go to Monsanto? Look into that, please. So it's Boycott with a U, Bicot. Really, really new stuff. Check it out. Download it as soon as you can. Check out the Outlaws of Health if you can. We are working on a documentary for HBO for Vice right now on the death of the organic farmer. And you can check us out on iTunes. It's a free thing to download as well, and we will keep fighting the good fight for you guys. And last but not least, that's voting with your dollar. Next time you spend a dollar, think about where it's going. Find out in a company, a Canadian company with integrity. Green Beaver's another great example, another body product that I use for myself, all organic, you can eat it all. I could talk forever about this stuff, but I want to leave you with a couple of things today. The world has enough for every person's need, but not every person's greed. We march for our rights, we march for our freedoms and our integrities, we march for our families, our children, and our futures. Thank you everyone for coming today.